In the battle with Moro, he only really became a problem after he devoured 7-3, one of his henchmen, who we find out now isn't actually a real person. He's not really anything. They go on to say about him, "You can't kill what's not alive," and so since the battle with Moro has passed, half of his head is still intact, and so he is still not alive, but around. This will lead to a bunch of different things. Right now, it is a guy called Granola, and he is going to steal him out of this healing chamber for his own purposes. And that's where the plot's going in Dragon Ball Super right now. It's interesting though, because this guy was in the previous arc, and I downplay him a lot because he didn't really do anything. He wasn't able to get past any of the main guys. They say that he's not alive, so essentially his artificial intelligence that can absorb information and techniques all around him. That's what he does. Instead of an army of 7-3s using an angel absorption ultra instinct technique, there is only going to be a reliance on just this one version of 7-3. They call him the OG 7-3. For whatever reason, this guy with an artificial eye patch, Granola, wants the powers of 7-3, or at least wants this version, and we can only go off what we know. 7-3 has absorbed the powers of Moro, who is able to absorb the powers of Mirus, an angel. There are a lot of people saying that this dude actually does look like an angel, and actually there's this one photo here that got sent to me. What if this is what an angel looks like that's stripped of their angel powers? That's a crazy idea. As we know, Mirus has been stripped of angel powers. Maybe Granola is too, and is trying to get back into the angel ranks by absorbing some of 7-3's power. He definitely has the hair for it. It's very angelic. But I guess all angel hairstyles are different. This is all going to be taking place when Goku and Vegeta are celebrating after the defeat of Moro, not knowing that they didn't quite finish the job with 7-3's head still being in the battlefield. Now, with the powers that he's absorbed, this Granola guy, he's going after something that 7-3 has, and all we know that 7-3 has is the ability to steal techniques, and the reason these angel theories are so prominent in the space is because, well, now that Goku's unlocked Ultra Instinct, the only guy that can verse him would be an angel. So if Granola is a fallen angel, if he can somehow scrape together some of that power back through 7-3, that would make him an angel. The only reason absorbing an angel didn't work for Moro is because his body wasn't honed for it. But if you were already previously an angel, your body is actually honed for it. And if you've just been converted back into a mortal, I don't think that would matter. You'd still be able to use your angel powers if you got them back through the use of 7-3. Very little is known about this new arc of Dragon Ball Super, but from what we've seen so far, that is my number one guess as to where this is all going. There's got to be some kind of connection with the angels. Goku knows Ultra Instinct. It's just got to be something like that. I mean, we can't have another mortal come out of nowhere and just be the strongest in the universe for no reason. Goku right now is number one, and the only thing that would be above him is a fallen angel. That is where I think this is all going. The title of the arc is called the Granola Arc, so whenever they name an entire saga after you, you're the main guy. He oozes main villain aura. He walks into this ship that's holding a bunch of 7-3s without smiling, looking very serious, without doing anything crazy. He takes on everybody. When he sees the 7-3 that's been torn apart and getting revived, that's when he smiles and says, "That's the one I want." Could he be an angel looking to resurrect his powers? We've never seen an evil angel before. Maybe now's the time. Or could he just be a mortal scientist loser? That's my take on basically the new arc and where I think it's gonna go. Very excited, very interested to see where this goes. Let me know what you think. I want to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next Dragon Ball video.